Wouldn't it be nice if your mold boxes went together and came apart easier than having to screw them together and using machines like this?
My name is Eric Strebel. Welcome to my channel about product design and making.
So I need to give credit to Jim Cheadle for the magnet idea. He is an artist out of the UK, and I will link to his website below. He does beautiful textural artwork that you can check out. I designed some PowerClick magnetic robots in the past, and I'll link to those on Amazon below. They basically allow a magnet inside of a space to rotate, and then the parts can connect in any kind of way, just like these toys do right here, and it'll work really good for this application. I'm going to start this project off by recycling the CAD data from the previous modular mold box that was all bolted together. So we'll scavenge the basic layout and reuse that for the circular neodymium 10 millimeter magnet system that we're going to use inside of the walls and the floor for this. The previous mold box was a 50 by 70, meaning 5 centimeters by 7 centimeter interior square volume. In this case, I'm going to go slightly bigger. I'm going to go 70 by 90 millimeters, or 7 centimeters by 9 centimeters for interior volume. It's a lot simpler to model in CAD, as I don't have all the through bolts and the washers, etc., etc., just the holes for the magnets to be buried, and I add a bigger logo on the bottom. Looks like a playing card, kind of cool. Oh, and if you're wondering, the walls are 50 millimeters high with 10 millimeter guidelines. Let's remove the support material from the 3D print. I'm able to do that with a pair of needle nose pliers fairly easy. Next, I'll use a dental tool to clean out the inside of the spaces where the spherical magnets will go. This is super important, as the magnets need to be able to rotate freely so that they can align to connect to the correct corresponding magnets on the other side of the piece. All right, once the magnets are in the correct hole, then a plug is needed to encapsulate them I found that using a file to file the mating surfaces nice and flat worked really, really well. And once the magnets were in there, it worked even better because it held the file flat to the surface. The plugs fit in really nice and snug. I designed them line to line so they pop in and they hold and stay in place nice and snug the way they should. That prevents the magnets from coming out. Occasionally, the plugs need a tiny little bit of persuasion, and it's super weird doing this because the head of the hammer actually is attracted by the magnet, and it makes for a weird hammering experience. A little bit more filing just to get the surface nice and flat so that when it mates up to the connecting wall, we'll get a good flat seal without any gaps. Now let's move on to the floor. Same thing here, insert the magnets, pop in the little plugs, go all the way around, and we're almost there. Assembly is pretty straightforward. You snap the pieces into place. Alignment is pretty automatic. Maybe some fine tuning is needed, but even a child could do it. It's pretty straightforward. The top comes off, and this allows you to then flip the mold over and reveal the part you just cast and tack on some more walls. Pretty straightforward, simple system. Going to be ideal, and I'm really looking forward to casting with these two modular systems to see how they work and what's more convenient and what works best for my workflow. Stay tuned for that.
At this point, I have two modular mold box systems. This one just snaps together with magnets, and this one from the previous video with bolts. This one's a little more secure. This one just faster, quicker, easier, more convenient. You want to make sure that you subscribe so that when I release videos in the future about using these mold boxes, you don't miss those videos and you can learn about how well these work.
Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Also, don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Links in the description below and on the channel page. Rock on! Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.